was tied at tonight's big football game between Rio Grande and Atrisco Heritage High Schools. That after vandals had earlier tagged buildings at Atrisco with taunts and foul language in red spray paint. New at 10, Action 7 News reporter Liz McCurtain joins us live from Milne Stadium with the latest.
Well, and even though the fighting words were on the walls all over Atrisco High, people here say that they were worried that perhaps anger from the vandalism would carry over into game time. But school officials, students, and even parents say they're relieved that that didn't happen.
The stands were near full tonight at Milne Stadium, but thankfully the action was all on the field, and fans say the talk wasn't all about the drama painted all over Atrisco High.
Here it's been pretty positive. There hasn't been too much talk.
I really haven't heard any talk about it, which surprised me. I thought there'd be a little more talk from some of the kids.
Early Friday morning, Atrisco Heritage students and parents arrived at school to see all of this. Red paint all over buildings and sidewalks, boasting about Rio Grande.
I just think that it's a shame that it's affecting this game and that people, you know, we have the police here for something that should have never happened.
Danielle Boronel's son plays for the Ravens and says the game shouldn't be surrounded by the controversy.
This is a game. It has nothing to do. I don't understand why they try to pit the schools against each other. These kids are here to have fun, to keep them out of trouble. And this is what happens. You know, it's terrible.
Officials say there was three times the regular amount of security because of the vandals. And while the game went on, fans on both sides say it's a relief that the focus stayed on the game and not on the crime.
And in the end, Atrisco High came out of this a mile ahead with the score of 35-6. And in a sense, so did the authorities, because at least at this point, there have been no arrests made here at the game. Reporting live from Milne Stadium, Liz McKernan, KYT, Action 7 News.
Well, school officials say there was around $10,000 worth of vandalism at Atrisco Heritage. They tell us there is video surveillance of the vandals, but have yet to release the photos.